Let's talk about very low density lipoproteins, VLDL. These are particles in the bloodstream, like LDL particles, HDL particles, and other things, that are the byproducts of both digestion and liver metabolism. So it's called VLDL, very low density lipoprotein, because it's very rich in triglycerides, that is fats, because fats are lighter than water, right? They're lighter than aqueous solutions. So that's why when you have Italian dressing, for instance, the olive oil floats. So the VLDL particle is very light, very fluffy and light, because it's filled with triglycerides or oil. But I also call the VLDL particle the life of the lipoprotein party. And the reason for that is VLDL particles like to interact with other particles. When it interacts with LDL particles, it contributes a lot of triglycerides to the LDL particle. And likewise, when VLDL interacts with the HDL particle, it contributes triglycerides. Now, when LDL particles and HDL particles become triglyceride enriched after meeting VLDL, they go through a series of reactions that make them much worse and harmful to you. LDL particles, bloated with triglycerides, become transformed into small LDL particles. Small LDL particles, not LDL cholesterol, that ridiculous kindergarten version of how heart disease is caused that suits the statin drug industry very well. Small LDL particles, the product of VLDL interaction with LDL particles, are very adherent to the arterial wall, thereby much more likely to cause atherosclerotic plaque. Once they get access into the wall, they're very adherent. They're much more likely to provoke inflammatory actions. They're much more oxidation and glycation prone. They're also much longer lasting because the liver can't recognize this abnormal LDL particle and sticks around for 5 to 7 days compared to the 24 hours of a large benign LDL particle. So that's what happens to LDL particles. HDL, now that it's triglyceride enriched from meeting VLDL, also goes through a similar series of reactions, and it makes the HDL particles small and relatively ineffective. Recall that HDL is protective for protects you from coronary disease, atherosclerotic heart disease. The HDL particle is now small and dysfunctional. So the VLDL particle, when abundant and when enriched in triglycerides, is a vigorous contributor of triglycerides to the LDL particle and to the HDL particle, making them much worse. So where do these VLDL particles come from? They come from the liver. When the liver is given lots of carbohydrates, okay, such as the amylopectin A of wheat and grains, sucrose, table sugar, fructose, that's rich in such things as agave nectar, high fructose corn syrup, sucrose, table sugar, honey, and maple syrup. Anything rich in fructose will cause this reaction. The reaction is called de novo lipogenesis. And all that means is that when you give your liver carbohydrates and sugars, it converts it to triglycerides. And the triglycerides are released into the bloodstream as VLDL. So the VLDL particle is pivotal. It's the one that leads to small LDL particles, the one that leads to dysfunctional and non-protective HDL particles. So anything that causes an increase in VLDL particles leads to heart disease, leads to all these problems. Carbohydrates do that, of course. And when your liver performs de novo lipogenesis, some of the triglycerides manufactured by the liver don't get out into the bloodstream. They stay in the liver. And that's how fatty liver develops. The key to not having VLDL particles is therefore to not consume foods that yield triglycerides and thereby VLDL particles, grains and sugars. You can track what your VLDL particles are doing. You could do a lipoprotein analysis, that's the best way, but you can also look at a conventional cholesterol panel and look at the triglycerides. You probably know I'm a vocal critic of cholesterol panels because most of the numbers on that panel are silly. Like a total cholesterol is completely worthless. LDL cholesterol is horribly inaccurate. It's a calculated number with the equation used to calculate it, invalidated by any reduction in carbohydrates in the diet. So those numbers are useless. But there's a triglyceride value. And triglycerides track very well with VLDL particles. So even if you don't have a VLDL measure, you have a triglyceride measure, which is a very good reflection of how much VLDL particles you have and whether you're contributing to fatty liver. We try to keep our triglycerides to 60 milligrams per deciliter or less. That's about 0.7 millimole per liter. How do you do that? Do my basic programs. We eliminate all wheat, grains, and sugars. We restore the factors that allow insulin sensitivity to be restored, like vitamin D, magnesium, fish oil, and we cultivate healthy bowel flora. All those factors make a contribution to not having excess VLDL, not having high triglycerides, and you're thereby spared from heart disease. I hope you appreciate how silly talk about the cholesterol in the LDL fraction is. We're really concerned about what VLDL is doing and how we create it, how we eliminate it.